two endurance. Today we'll be looking at the NECA Last Ronin thing. I can figure out whatever you want to call it. I don't know. And this is the armored version. And yeah, let's take a look at the box art. Oh, and before we get into the box art, this, if you get the unarmored Rathio, I think the robot and Donnie and Splinter, I don't know if those would be those, but if you keep the boxes, they actually make a picture, so you can see the unarmored version arm right there, and yeah, so you can make a poster with it. So here we have the Last Ronin, aka Mikey. Here it says Last Ronin, armored Nickelodeon, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, The Last Ronin, and for The Last Ronin, for the stand, we actually have three of The Last Ronin books. The rest are up there. And we'll use that for, like, comparisons. But we won't get into that right away. And yeah, I showed you the side. We got The Last Ronin, aka Mikey, then the tower, then Mikey's unarmored version's arm right there. And then on the back we have the second cover for the second issue. Then we have Last Ronin, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Last Ronin. Here's his bio. Here are the other pictures of him. And then here we have cover A for the first issue. Then up there we got TMNT, Last Ronin, Make It Faster, Nickelodeon. And then on the, oh my gosh, on the bottom we have some NECA. We have NECA, oh, this is actually upside down. Who cares? NECA, the barcode, and other stuff. I'm bored with that. And then on the top here's like the Last Ronin and stuff, Warning, and Nickelodeon. And it also like has a flap right here. I'm just open it up real quick. I just have a piece of Velcro on it. Here. There's the figure. There is a little display piece right there. And before we get into this, there's slashes like right there and on the top and on the bottom, like all over. And like the top. Like on the top and the side. That, let me move this, comparison time with the box, it's the same here, like the comic book rip here. You see on this one, the comic book rip. But yeah, let's get into this. Okay, here is Mikey, aka the Last Ronin, out of the box and the packaging. But first we will take a look at some of the accessories. I won't go through all of them, but you guys probably, like, should know the video about this guy. So yeah, so we'll go over the hands first. So you get two of these opened hands, like from that scene, from the, like one of the pages where he's like looking around with these types of hands. And then the hands he comes with, like he has on, I replaced these hands for those hands. And that's, I'm gonna keep it like that way because I took the hands off and some of the plastic on the thing came off, but yeah. And he comes with these hands, two of these. This is one I have, and the other one's in the packaging still. Same for this one. Then we'll look at the interchangeable head, because we're already looking at the like interchangeable thing. And then we have this head from the scene where he's coughing out blood. Remember when he falls from the building and he's coughing up blood and stuff? Yeah, but there's no blood. It's just his mouth like that. I'll display him like this, but with this. Keep going. Then another thing they had to do that was unbelievable was this. I'm zooming a bunch. Check focus. There you can see the little ball. It's a bomb. Yeah. Oh, and be careful when you open them. Open it really slowly, the packaging, because when I opened it, some of these things went flying out. Here's, you get 4 ninja stars, but I only took 2 out, so. Yeah, the other two are in the packaging. The grappling hook is in the packaging. It's like you see on the box. It's just like that and a bit of rope, so yeah. And then we get the katana. No, I don't want to pull that, but yeah, here it is. And then we get Donnie's bow staff. Mikey's nunchucks with real chains. I like that. For a period of time, I actually worked with nunchucks for a bit, but I don't know why I stopped. Then here we have the Sai, a protection weapon. Not used to stab or anything, to protect yourself. Then we got the tong, or I think that's how you say it, the tong.
Hello?
Yeah. This is a long part right here, but if we go back on the box art, you can see it's short. People have trimmed it down, but I don't want to risk breaking it. And plus, it's good as it is. I don't want to mess with it. Then we got his goggles. Pretty nice. And also, the rope part fabric-y. Like that stretchy fabric. Then you got the bandana, so you can take off the hood, then there'll be a little plug in the back where you'll put this on. You can also do it with this hood too, but the weird part is they're not the same size. 2 different sizes, but this one's long, this one is short. But yeah, now I'll show you how I will display this guy, because some of the plastic's coming off of his wrist when I take them up. But yeah, I'll show you how I'll display this guy. Okay, this is how I'll be displaying this guy. And let's go over the articulation. The head moves, but I don't want to move it because of the goggles. They're pretty good at the way they are. Right now, the nunchucks are in the back. He does have an ab crunch, and he does have 2 elbow joints, one right here and one up here. His shoulders are pretty tight, but I don't really care. His wrists move. Ab crunch, of course. I told you about his legs, his thigh swoles. He has, mine are kind of stiff a little bit, but his knee, bends both ways. He has his foot goes up and down, swivels too. Yeah, that's pretty much it for this guy. This is like a comic book version. That's why it doesn't look super real. It looks kind of comic-y because these are from the comics. And yeah, be careful with the side. It's really pointy. I actually poked myself. The side goes here. The bow staff, the katana goes back there. It's kind of hard. And yeah, you can barely see it, but I've got paint rub on the katana, like on the sheath of the katana. Bow staff fits in there nicely. The bomb fits in there nicely. Hey, let me put that in there better so it doesn't pop out. There. Yeah. This is kind of a short video. Like, NECA, like, they're a very good toy company. I'm not gonna pose them with the... I forgot what this is called. Oh my gosh. With this because I put it in there, but like his, like since it's so, it's made weird, like kind of poke, like it's up down like that kind of rubber, and if you try to put it in there, it's kind of like rubbed on it, but I might be able to put it in there, but I don't know, I'm still deciding. But yeah, so let's grab the Playmate toys that's drawn and compare it with the NECA that's drawn. You can see in size difference, it's like, it's very big. Glasses, they're different, they're not completely red. It's like a red dot inside the black, like that one. But I wouldn't blame it because this isn't like stuff that's good for accurate. It goes for toys wise. This is all one piece. Like you can, it's like it has a lot more pieces than this one, but this one has a lot more accessories than this one. This one has like more weapons and stuff. And this one has less weapons and more like accessories. If YouTube lets me have comments, don't blame me if I got that wrong. But yeah, the back's all one piece. The nunchucks have nowhere to go, But for this one, the grappling hook and the tongue have nowhere to go. So, which one do I like best? Obviously the NECA one, but for like little kids, the Playmates one. Because this one, it's not very good for playing around with. You can play around with it. But it wouldn't be the best if we were to make another one for kids. They would make the hands like move, the fingers movable, because mine, I switched them out a couple times, and the plastic right here on like this part actually comes off, so that's why I'm keeping them with those hands. So yeah, I'll show you how I'll display them right now.
They're the heroes for, in this day and age, who could ask for more? The crime wave is high, with muggings mysterious. All police and detectives are furious, cause they can't find the source of this lethally evil force. This is serious, so give me a quarter. I was a witness, get me a reporter. Call April O'Neill in on this case, hey, you better.